Prime Time News on FanLaCenter.com on August 24th, 2008, and I'm Shekhar with some major news of the day. But first, the headlines. Indefinite curfew imposed in Kashmir. Agitation launched against Singur Tata project in West Bengal. Vishwa Hindu Parisan leader shot dead in Odisha. And India set a target of 238 for Sri Lanka. Now the news in detail. Indefinite curfew was imposed in all 10 districts of the Kashmir Valley this morning, and several separatist leaders were placed under house arrest in a bid to disallow a march to the city centre on Monday. The march has been called by the separatist leader after massive show of strength on Friday, in which many Kashmiri marched to the Eidgah lawn to offer prayers. According to the sources, separatist leaders including Sayyed Ali Gilani, Mir Vej Amur Farooq, Shabir Ahmad Shah and Muhammad Yasin Malik have been placed under house arrest and no visitors are allowed to their house. Thousands of protesters today joined the massive agitation launched by the Trinamool-led Krishi Javi Jeevan Jeevika Raksha Committee demanding the return of 400 acres of farmland acquired by the Tata for the Nano project. The protester warned the left front government to return 400 acres of the total taken to build ancillary industries adjacent to the main auto plant. They claimed that their lands were acquired forcefully by the government from the farmers who were unwilling to surrender the land for the project. Samajwadi Party leader Amar Singh, social activist Medha Patkar and Kuldeep Nair are also expected to join the agitation. Well, it's time for a short break, but we'll be back in a moment. Stay tuned. Welcome back. At least five people, including a top leader of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad, were shot dead in an ashram in Orissa's Kandamal district by an armed group during the Janmashtami festival celebration on Saturday. Over 20 armed people started firing in an ashram in Orissa's Kandamal district where these people were gathered for Janmashtami celebration. However, the police still could not confirm whether attacks were Maoist guerrillas. India has set a target of 238 for Sri Lanka in the third ODI of the India Cup at the Premdasa Stadium in Colombo. Electing to bat first after winning the toss, India had a formidable start, but wicket kept falling in quick succession after the dismissal of Virat Kohli at 39. However, Suresh Raina and Skipper MS Dhoni played a decent knock and helped the side set a defendable total. K. Kulaskera and Tushara claimed 2 wickets, while Mendis once again struck the Indian batsmen and dismissed 3 of them. Well, that's all for now, but for more news and update, keep logging on to our website, headlinesindia.com. Goodbye and take care.